The final step of your self-portrait project is to finish off your background, and I've chosen to do mine as a collage. You could certainly choose to do yours as a drawing, but either way, it might be helpful to cut your portrait all the way out and do your background on a separate piece of paper. It just makes it a lot easier to avoid the problem of having to draw or collage around the shape of your portrait, which in many cases is really kind of awkward and has lots of really strange little nooks and crannies. The other advantage, especially if you're doing collage, is that it gives you the opportunity to really think about your design layout before you commit to gluing everything down and really playing around with overlapping and making sure everything really fits together and that you have covered the entire surface of your background. Same thing if you're doing drawing. So this picture, for example, would be really difficult to cut out and then try to put around my portrait if it were already glued down. If you are using collage, make sure that you get a piece of scratch paper to use as the place to do your gluing so that you're not accidentally getting glue on your portrait or on other areas that you didn't intend to. So here it is, it's finished, it's complete. Every area of that background is totally covered with collage. If you're drawing, you want the whole surface of your background to also be covered with images that pertain to your character in some way or tell a story or give us information about the background. You can see when we zoom in that there are things that look like they're really behind me because I did that background on a separate piece of paper. So, if only clones did exist, wouldn't that be amazing?